My name is Alfred Peterwhite. I am 65 years old. I am from Adelaide. I've always been living on the road in my van. This is the first home that I've ever had in 20 years, and it's wonderful. I had a bad marriage breakdown. Too many people trying to adjust my life. I ended up under a psychiatrist taking tablets for my nerves, and I just decided that I would just take off, and that's where it started from. My form of transport was mainly a van, and I moved around in the van. I slept in the van, changed clothes in the van, eat in the van, read books. It's kitchen, lounge, dining room, the whole lot, and got work wherever I could. I wasn't on the road for 12 months. I was on the road for 20 years. Yeah, I did this because I didn't want my family to know where I was. Always had to cover my tracks. One of the things that people can track you is on the election roll. When I left South Australia, my plan was to go off the election roll. If I registered the car in, say, the Gold Coast and the driver's license, I would go to another place. Well, it's living rough. You live on canned foods, your hygiene deteriorates. Sometimes you don't have a shower for a week. You don't change your clothes for a month. But self-hygiene, you don't care about it no more. You think, what the hell, you know? And that's what it is. My nerves were absolutely shot. I'd get a half a cup of coffee and spill it, and I knew myself I had to change, because otherwise I'd just deteriorate. Tried many organisations, but they didn't sort of want to help you. And I just took a bloke one day who was just mostly upset, thinking, well, it's a lot easier to go back on the road than what it is. And he told me about this program. And it's been wonderful. Well, the worker actually made me feel that I really have to change my ways. They're there to help me, understands me, put me on the right track to other things I can do. Mm-hmm. The first time I met it was great. You really know that the person that they're dealing with, it's not just a job to them. It's part of the commitment. You can tell that person is not going to work because she likes the job. It's because she cares about the job. And anybody can feel that. And that's what makes you a lot more better, when you know that somebody really does care. For the first time in 20 years, I've got a place that's not moving. Not on wheels. Yeah, this is the first unit I've ever had. A lot of things you don't understand. Electricity, rent. You've got to adjust to this. I didn't have rent with the van. All I had was registration, fuel. The worker got me into the white grant, and so I can get a fridge, washing machine, and got $100 to work and spend on dinner sets and all that. But there's a lot of good second-hand furniture in the Salvation Army that's absolutely wonderful. Nobody would know this second-hand if I didn't tell them. It's like new, you know. You've got to make it look a home. You've got to get some of these little things that makes it look home. It's not just putting furniture in the place, it's decorations. I bought two bears to turn out big rabbits. It just makes it look homely, and you really got to do that. Christmas to me was nothing. It's another day. This year's going to be a bit mostly. Because now I've got grandchildren. It's mostly, but one way I'm happy. A little things, like Grandpa, God, it's good to feel wanted. Somebody looking out, get the help. It'll change your life and you'll be a lot better off. This program helps you a great deal because it changes emotionally, health-wise, everything else. And it gives you a bit of dignity back into your life, whereas before you don't have any dignity and your health will improve 100%. This program's for older people. Bring up a source for cancer and they'll put you onto it. What makes it wonderful is the people that is there understands the way they show it. It's not just their personal features that shows you, not just, you're not a number, and you can tell that, and that's partly what it is. And you feel happy that somebody really cares and understands you. Home means to me, it's pride, security. It really is security, and that's what it really means to me. Where you can come home, sit down, relax, watch TV. You can't watch TV in the van. Just relaxing, and it really is. It means a great deal to me.